Good afternoon. I'm Susan Shapiro. Today's top story, a private meeting this afternoon between prosecutors, attorneys for convicted child molester Jerry Sandusky and the judge who will oversee Sandusky's sentencing tomorrow on 45 counts of child sex abuse. News 8's Matt Barcaro is live outside the Center County Courthouse to tell us more about what's going to happen this afternoon. Hi, Matt.
Hi, Susan. That meeting is supposed to start in about 2 hours. Both sides will be meeting with the judge essentially to hash out how tomorrow's sentencing hearing will go down. It'll be a day of last chances, a last chance for the victims to confront Sandusky in court and a last chance for Sandusky to defend himself. We know that first thing in the morning tomorrow, there will be a special hearing for the judge to decide if Sandusky will be considered a sexually violent predator. That determination would affect Sandusky if he would ever to be released from prison, but his defense attorney has even said that he doesn't believe that will happen. So unless the defense puts up some type of fight to fight the sexually violent predator status, that hearing might only last a couple of minutes, and then immediately following will be the sentencing when the judge will determine how long Sandusky will spend in prison. We're expected to hear from at least some of the victims themselves as they tell the judge why they want Sandusky locked up. And we could also hear from Sandusky himself. I talked to his lead defense attorney, Joe Amendola, a couple of weeks ago, and he had said that Sandusky has been spending a lot of time in prison writing down a statement of his account of what happened for all these accusations. And we could hear from Sandusky directly in court today. And if that happens, that would be the first time we've heard directly from him since a few months before the trial when he spoke right outside these courthouse steps. He did not take the stand in his own defense during the trial. If Judge John Cleland decides to throw the book at Sandusky, he could spend more than 200 years in prison, definitely a life sentence. We'll see tomorrow what those years will be. Susan?
And Matt, my understanding, he will first go to Camp Hill State Prison and then on to possibly another prison?
That'll be one of the first stops for him. They'd have to go to Camp Hill Prison in Lower Allen Township to get processed, to go through a series of screenings, and then they'll determine which prison within the state system to send him to permanently.
All right, very good. Thank you, Matt.